Hello everyone, as we have studied in the previous classes, in the previous videos, we have seen the different aspects of actually what is management we have studied, and we have studied in the previous classes the things that you are going to study in this particular course, Introduction to Management and Function. Then we have studied in the previous about the management key concepts, the different terms which you are going to come across this particular course of study, that is organization's goal, then the management, organization performance, then efficiency and effectiveness. So let us carry on from where we left out. So next is we are talking about the introduction to management. And as you at presently, after seeing the previous videos of this particular course or subject, I think now presently you do have some basic idea about what is management. As you can see, the first point, one of the most important human activity is managing. That means every human being has that capability to manage the activities. That means every human being he has to do certain day-to-day related core activities. That means every human being he has the ability to manage. That means we can say that every human being has that management qualities to manage his or her life. But what we do not know that this particular term is used at this particular time, like planning, directing, scheduling, and all those terms which will come across. Now, this particular management, it is the most important human activity which we do it at every point of time, every day, every second, we can say. Then, the second point you can see. Managing has been an essential to ensure the coordination of individual tasks. Now, as in the second point, he says that this particular managing has been an essential to ensure the coordination. That means this particular management tries to bring the people who are working in the organization together to bring a kind of sense of coordination between the people who are working under a particular organization, and that it ensures this particular management, it ensures that everyone will work towards a single organizational goal. Okay, so next one is the task of managers is rising in importance. As we all know that managing the things is much more important nowadays. So the tasks these managers, the managers of any of the organization or any of the department they does, it is of utmost importance. So next is this is all about the introduction to management, which we have read. It's the most important human activity, and it brings a kind of coordination between the members of the organization, and the task of the managers is much more important nowadays. Now the concept of management. Now we study this particular concept of management in three alternative ways. That is, in the when we talk about the three alternative ways, we can just try to learn this particular concept of management in three different ways. So the first one is management as a discipline. Okay, management as a discipline then comes as the management as a group of people and management as a process. So these are the three aspects by which the concept of management can be learned in the three alternative ways. Now coming to the first point, that is management as a discipline. Now, management as a discipline actually refers to what? Actually, it refers to the branch of knowledge which is connected to study of. So, it's that particular branch of knowledge which it is totally connected to the study of the principles and practices of the basic administration in any organization. Now, if you go in depth, that means this management, it has a particular code of conduct which has to be followed by the manager, and various management methods for managing the organizational resources efficiently. So, I hope you have understood. So, what I'm trying to say is the management as a discipline is it is that particular branch where we do have knowledge, where we find different management principles, and we find different management practices or case studies of basic management, basic administration, which you find in an organization. And we do have a code of conduct which every manager has to follow in his or her organization, and also there are various other methods to actually how to utilize the organizational resources in a better way. So, this is what about the first point, as we are talking about the concept of management, where the one of the alternative ways management as a discipline. Now, the second point is management as a group. Now, management as a group of people, it actually refers to what? It actually refers to those persons who actually perform the task of managing an organization. Then a group, when we talk technically, it includes all managers from the top level managers to the low level managers. So all these managers are all these people who are the part of the organization. They perform the tasks to manage the organization in a right path in order to achieve the organizational goal which has been fixed it beforehandedly. Okay, so this is called as management. In this context, it is called as a management as a group of people. Now, the third context is management as a process. Now, management as a process is like we can say setting the goals, setting the goals. How do we set goals? See, we cannot set, or an organization cannot fix a goal or set a goal and sit idle. So for that, what we have to do is we have to, after setting the goals, we have to plan, then planning and controlling the organizing, and we have to lead the execution of any type of activity as a project or a process. Now, who is actually responsible for the management as a process or management process? So, the organization's senior most management or senior most manager is actually responsible for carrying out this management process. So, management, after setting up what should be the goal, we should. We are indirectly talking about the different functions of the management. That is, after planning, we are what we are doing is after planning, we are directing it, then organizing, then staffing, then controlling. So these are all the things which actually we are reading about the concept of management in three alternative ways. That is, management as a discipline, management as a group of people, and management as a process. I hope you have understood this particular concept of management. Now, what is management? Now, as we have already gone through this particular term, what is management? And you can see here, if management is a field of study which has certain management principles and management techniques, then functions, etc. And so, based on this particular things, we are actually we can also define what is management based on the field of study. So, management means which are having different principles, different management techniques, different functions by which we can run an organization in the most efficient and effective way. Then you can also say the team or a class of people. So the management is also, you can say it can be an individual who is performing a set of managerial activities, or it can be a group of persons. So what I am actually trying to do here is, you can see the previous topic, that is the concept of management in three alternative ways, and what is management? These two are totally correlated with each other. In that concept of management, you have management as a discipline, and here we have field of study. There, second concept was management as a group of people, and here we have team or class of people. And similarly, the third one, management as a process. Here also you can find the definition, what is management, as a third point as process. So the team or class of people is any of the individual. As I told you, each and every one of us, irrespective of what background he is, whether he is educated or uneducated, if he can perform a certain activity in the most effective way, then I can say, or anyone can say, that he or she has that particular managerial skills or activity, or he can perform that particular activity in the most efficient way and effective way. And or it can be an individual, or it can be a group of persons. So the third point is the process. As I was speaking about, the management can be also be a management process, where different managerial activities are done, like planning, as we have read already, planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. Okay, so these are the things about this particular topic, what is management. Now, coming to the definition of management. So definition of management, I'll be taking a lot, because we have different definitions which come for this particular word. When you as the definition of management, we do have an individual definitions of management. Now, when what is management, if anyone asks you, or what is the best definition of management, if I say, if you ask me, then you can say that if I or it is the act of getting things done through others and having them do it willingly. That means, don't think it is an easier concept, or a easier way, where whatever just I have told you, if you have the ability to make things done by others very easily. And suppose if you are giving a particular person a particular work, that you have to do this particular work within a stipulated time, and if that person, if he is willingly, he is willing to do that particular work, to whom you have scheduled a particular work or allotted a particular work, then you can say, then, or I can say, that you have that particular capability of, you have that particular management technique, where you can, you have that particular art of doing or getting things done by other persons. Okay, so that is what it is. That particular first definition, or you can say, as per me, it is the best definition given by F.W. Taylor, that it is an art of knowing what you want to do, and then seeing whether it is done in the best or cheapest way. That means, what he is trying to say is, management is an art of what. See, it is an art where you should know actually what you are doing. Okay, now presently what you are doing, you are listening to the video, or you are watching the video. Okay, that you should have at least that capability, or you should have at least that consciousness, that you should know at least what you are doing presently. Okay, if you have that particular art of what actually you are going to do, or what you are doing presently, and what you are going to do in future, and what you have done in the past, and whatever you are going to do in the future, if you can do that particular thing in the best way and the cheapest way, that particular art is known as management. This is according to F.W. Taylor. Now, according to Henry Fayol, management is to manage. He says that management means is to forecast. forecasting means or you cannot say prediction. Okay, there is a lot of difference between prediction and forecasting. You might have heard the word weather forecast. In forecasting, what they does is they take the past data into consideration. Okay, so the previous actual data is taken into consideration whenever they do forecast the things. Forecasting, what you can do weather forecast, you can do the what will be the population that you can forecast. Okay, you can forecast the sales of the product, you can forecast the demand of the product, everything you can forecast. But prediction is totally different. Predictions, you are not taking into you are not taking into account the subjective considerations. But whereas in forecast, you have to take into account the subjective considerations. Okay, so tomorrow what will be the temperature? Okay, suppose suppose the date is August 23rd, 2020. Tomorrow what will be the temperature if you want to forecast? Okay, August 23rd, 2019, go in backward direction, get the temperature of August 23rd, 2019, 2018, 2017, last 10 years, and simply take the average of the last 10 years, and it will be, I'm not saying it will be exactly the same temperature tomorrow, whatever the average that you have calculated. Okay, so there are different things. What I am actually trying to say over here is you will be somewhat nearer, or there may be a possibility that whatever you have estimated the temperature that this will be tomorrow, and the actual which you are going to get it from the Google weather, that whatever is the difference, that is called as a forecast error. So he is saying that management means the forecast. That means we are directly relating to this as the organizational goal. You see, the organizational goal, you are forecasting it, that this will be my organization, this is the organizational goal. Okay, so for to forecast, to actually achieve that particular goal, you have to plan it. After planning, you have to organize the things as per the plan, and you have to command, to coordinate, and to control. So all these are the functions of the management, or the management process, which actually Henry Fayol has included in his definition. So according to one more person, Peter F. Drucker, as I already told you, management is the work as such has which has who has its own skills and own tools and own techniques. That means it is a kind of work where that particular, as I can say, that each and every individual, whether it is a gents or a lady, he or she has his or her own set of skills. You have your own what you can say, techniques, how to solve a particular problem if it arises before you at any point of time. You have your own techniques to solve it in whatever problems you are going to face in your life in future. So similarly, management, you can treat it as a kind of work where you have your own skills and own tools and own techniques. So this is as per Peter F. Drucker. Now management is the fourth one. Definition is, it is art of getting things done through and with people. As I was speaking about this, I consider as the best definition of management. It is as per me. So there may be your own definition of management as per you. So management is the art of getting things done willingly. That means if I'll be getting things done, whatever I want that you all of you should do this particular work, if I am getting it done by your own willingness, then I have that particular management quality to get the things done by other people. So this is all about what we are speaking about, the definition of management, and the four definitions given by F.W. Taylor and Henry Fayol and Peter Drucker, and one more important definition, as you should not forget throughout your lifetime, it's the art of getting things done through other people willingly. So I hope you have understood this particular lecture. And thank you for your patience listening. In the next class, we'll be studying about the different context of defining management and other things. I hope you have enjoyed the class. Okay, thank you very much.